Hi everyone, if you want to access your USB drive that is attached to the USB port of your router from anywhere in the world through the internet, keep watching this video. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. If you find the content of my channel interesting, please take a moment to subscribe. It only takes a second, it is free, and it will help my channel greatly. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can access a USB drive that is connected to my Asus router from anywhere in the world using OpenVPN server. There are mainly two steps to achieving this: configuring the router and then configuring the client so that for it to be able to access the USB key that is on the router. And I'm gonna walk you through all these configurations. Let's start first by configuring the router. In my example, I'll be using an Asus RT-AC68U router, but the instructions I'm gonna show you will also apply to all routers that use the OpenVPN server and that has a USB port where you can plug a USB drive to share it. There are three main steps to configuring the router. First, creating a DDNS entry. The second one is enabling the OpenVPN server. And the third one is enabling USB sharing on the router. So let's start by creating a DDNS entry. Start by logging in to your router's administration page. So this is the Asus router administration page. And then go to one. And under one, you have DDNS. So now we are in the DDNS tab of our Asus router. All we have to do here is click on yes, so that to enable it. And here you need to choose a public domain so that to assign your DDNS entry to it. For Asus, it will give you a free domain on asus.com. By the way, if you have a router that doesn't give you a free domain name like Asus does here, I have previously created a video on how to create a DDNS name with no IP. You can find a link to this video in the description. So here we are going to use the asus.com domain. And for the host name, I'm gonna name it kstech1969. And then here Asus will give you the option to create a certificate. Of course, it's better to create a certificate. Otherwise, if you don't want to create a certificate, or if your router doesn't allow you to create a certificate easily, just select none. Here, I'm gonna keep it on free certificate from Let's Encrypt. So all you have to do here is to click on apply. And if the host name is not taken by someone else, it will give you a message saying registration is successful. Click on OK. And the second step here is to enable OpenVPN on your router. So on the left, scroll until you find VPN, click on it. So here, click on OpenVPN, and we need to enable OpenVPN server. So toggle this switch to on, keep VPN details on general. For the server port, here you need to choose a port from 1024 to 65535. This is the recommendation of Asus. So here I'm gonna choose 1969. And for the RSA encryption, you have two options. I'm gonna put it on 2048. This is a better encryption. It will be a bit slower than 1024, but it's better for security. And here you have the option, client will use VPN to access local network only or internet and local network. So I'm gonna keep it on internet and local network. And here there are advanced settings also. I'm not gonna go through them because by default they are good on Asus routers. I'm just gonna show them to you. So if you click on VPN details and choose advanced settings, you can choose here a bunch of things that you can change, but keep them by default and they will work. So keep it on general. Now we need to precise what users have access to this VPN connection. So if you scroll, you're gonna find on the bottom the users. By default, the admin user of the router has full access to this VPN connection. So here I'm gonna create another user. Click in the field under username. So let's name the user kstech. And here you need to know that the username is case sensitive. And the password, of course, it is also case sensitive. So here I'm gonna put for the purpose of this video any password. So it's VPN pass 1969. And then click on the plus sign to create the user. And then click on apply. The last step in configuring the OpenVPN server is to export the OpenVPN configuration file. So here under Export OpenVPN Configuration File, click on Export. By default, the configuration file name is client.ovpn. So I'm gonna leave it as it is, and then I'm gonna save this file to a USB key so that I can import this file on the client after. So let's go to the USB key under this PC. This is my USB key. I'm gonna click on save here. So the file is now saved on the USB key. The last configuration that we need to do on the router now is to enable USB sharing on the router. Of course, after you insert the USB key in your router's USB port. Under the configuration page here of your router, go to USB application. And for SS router, it is under servers center. So here you can enable the SMB sharing. So click on server center or on the equivalent on your router. And we need to share the USB under network place Samba. So click on it here. And then you need to enable the share. So toggle this one to on. And then click on OK. And the settings will be applied. So here, keep everything by default. And then also by default, the SS router will give the admin user of the router access to all the USB key. So here we need to create a user so that we select what access we need to give to this user. And I'm gonna show you this. So let's click on the plus sign to create a user. You need to put the username here and put the password and then reconfirm the password. So I'm gonna fill these fields now. So this is a user I'm creating, KSTechSMB1969 with the password that is SMBPass1969. So I'm gonna click on add. And now the user is created. We still need to give access to this user to the folders under the USB key. So click on the user, and here on the right, the router will show you the USB key. So this is my USB key. Click on it, and it will start opening the USB tree. And also click on here, and then you can find the folders that are in the USB key. By the way, the SS router will not let you share the root of the USB key. So you need to select the folders. And here by default, you see that when you create a new user, it will not give it access to anything. So the access is no. I'm gonna give it read-write access to documents and read access to the videos folders and the USB key. And then I'm gonna click on save. And these are all the settings that we need to configure on the router. Now I'm gonna switch to the client. So to show you how to configure it to access this USB key through the VPN server. This here is a PC that is connected to the internet. The first step that we need to do on the client PC is to insert the USB that has the OpenVPN configuration file. After we insert the USB, let's open a web browser, and then we need to download the OpenVPN Connect client. And this here is a Windows 11 PC. By the way, if you want me to show you these steps on another client, let me know in the comments section below, and I'll be happy to answer all your comments and all your questions. So here we need to go to openvpn.net, and then you need to click on products, and you see Connect Client, click on it. And here we're gonna choose the Windows application, and we need to click on download OpenVPN Connect. Once it is downloaded, we need to open it so that to install the OpenVPN Connect. So click on open here. It will be open directly, and then it will install. Let me minimize the browser. Let's click on next. And then here we need to accept the agreement, next, and install. Click yes if prompted. And this is OpenVPN client installed. Let's close the help screen here. We don't need it. Let's agree to the agreement and okay. So this is OpenVPN launched automatically after finishing the setup. Of course, you can launch it also with its icon here. And here you need to click on file. So to import the file that is on the USB key. So click on file, click on browse. And let's go to the USB key. And this is the file here, select it, and then click on open. So this will configure automatically the VPN connection. All we have to do here is to put the username, and remember that the username is case sensitive. So KSTech in capital letters, and then click on connect. And here it will prompt you for the password. So VPN pass 1969. Let's check if the password is correct. Yes, so let's click on OK, and now it should connect to our VPN. So now we are connected to our network from an external PC. Wherever it is in the world, you can perform this and connect to your network. So now the purpose of this video is to show you how to access the USB shared on your router from anywhere on the internet. So now to be able to access the USB that is shared on the router, we need to get the IP address of the router. So I'm gonna switch to the screen that shows the admin page of the router. To get the information of the router, this is what you need to do. Click on the LAN here, and simply you get the IP address of the router from here. So it is 192.168.1.1. And you can use this IP to access the shared USB key on the router. So So let me switch back to the client to show you how to connect to this IP and to the USB key. So now we are at the client. Let's open File Explorer. And in File Explorer, you need to put this IP address. So backslash backslash 192.168.1.1 and hit enter. And you're gonna see that you're gonna be able to access the USB key. Well, let's double click on documents here to authenticate. And here it will ask you for the username and password that you use to secure your USB share on the router. So remember, we have put KSTECH SMB 1969 as a username, and as a password we have put SMB pass 1969. So let's click on OK, and we will be authenticated on the USB share. And you see here that we have like files on this share, so I can delete a file, for instance, because we have read write access to this share, as you remember. So you can also copy files, for instance, from the USB key and to the USB key. And this is the beauty of having access to your USB drive from anywhere in the world. So you can transfer files from and to your home network. Let me show you very quickly now how the videos share is only read only. So I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna double click on videos. And because we authenticated, we don't need to re-authenticate. So here, for instance, you cannot create anything because it's read only. So if I try to create like a bitmap image, it's not gonna let me, but I can play the file if I want to. So hi, this everyone. Is a file
a couple of played. Years ago.
So that was it for this video. I hope that you liked this video and you found it useful. If you did, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and this will help my channel greatly. And this way, you'll not miss my future videos. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. I wanna thank you all for watching, and see you in the next video.